I will never tire of repeating that the sideload of third-party applications belongs to the nature of Firefox OS, which is the heart of KaiOS. The KaiOS tech side itself, in the developers section, explains in detail how to configure the system to develop applications, using the KaiOS emulator or above all by activating debugging on your device, through the settings menu. Unfortunately, the reality is quite different. To activate the developer menu on the device, it is necessary to make a privileged factory reset, for now possible through our apps, Omni SD or Wallace. We have divided the devices studied and enabled for this function into three categories, depending on the difficulty of the process: simple, medium and hardcore. Simple, ADBM dev tools, dial hash number 33284 #, to enable USB debugging. A bug icon should appear in the taskbar. For now, the devices are the new Nokia 2720 Flip, 800 TUF and 8110 4G, MTN Smart S 3G, sold in Africa, and Alcatel Cingular Flip 2, in the United States. Medium, ADBM dev tools, dial hash number 33284 #, and after hash number 0574 #, to enable the debugging USB. For now, the devices are Positivo P70S, from Brazil, and Energizer E241s. Hardcore, no working codes or ADB debugging, then use EDL tools and you can flash a patch data partition, then you can get root. The devices currently classified in this category are Jio Phone and Jio Phone 2, sold in India, and CAT B35. We do not know exactly how many other devices can be placed in the hands of those who want to develop applications, so what are the best KaiOS devices to buy? But based on the aforementioned categories, we can already hypothesize classifications, based on the strange behavior of some of these devices under study on our channels. Based on the signaling boom that we have received in these hours on our Discord channel, we can deduce that the brand new Alcatel Go Flip 3 by AT&T and Alcatel MyFlip by TracFone, from the United States, and also the new Blue Zoey Smart, from Venezuela, which have a working debug code that allows access to ADB but they do not have debugger socket, are certainly classifiable in the hardcore category. The same fate will also affect Sigma X-style S3500 sKai, sold in Russia, and Maxcom MK241, which do not have working codes, nor ADB access points, while for Doro devices ADB access is possible by restarting in FFBM from phone off, but no codes anyway. Six devices we are studying, coming from various countries of the world and whose researchers need your help. However, given the endless possibilities of the above-mentioned Energizer Energy E241s, which we support, in the medium category, it would be interesting to confirm the same for the entire Energizer family. If you have an Energizer Energy E220s or E220 or a Hardcast H241, H242, H242s or H280s, try to enable USB debugging through these codes I wish to repeat. Hash number 33284 #, and then later hash number 0574 #. Other devices without researcher are Multilaser Zap, from Brazil, Orange Sanza, from Cameroon, Ooredoo, Middle East, Techno T901, from Africa, and the enigmatic and hypothetical Wiz Phone WP006, which should be sold in Indonesia. If you are in possession of one of these KaiOS devices or want to tell us one not present in this list, do not hesitate to contact us. Your feedback will also be a valuable help for other people like you who don't know how much potential is contained in KaiOS devices. Subscribe to my channel to stay constantly updated on any developments of this research. Because we alone are nothing, but all together we are so much. Thanks for your attention. See you next. BananaHackers.net. Join the revolution.